Well, hello and welcome back to Noah's Window. As we wrap up the week this week, I want to go back to Matthew chapter 7 where Jesus is speaking. We started there back at the beginning of the week. And when we were talking about that earlier in the week, I mentioned the fact that we're planning on starting with the book of Matthew. When we do book by book, that'll begin, Lord willing, in January. So one quick note on that before we jump into today's scripture is our registration is up to 115. And I just found out yesterday that we only have 122 chairs. So we'll be having to close registration here pretty soon, which is kind of sad. If we can find a way to add more people, we'll try to do that. But in case you haven't registered yet, you can still go until it's full. The registration link is newspring.org/bookbybook. So hope you can be there. I'm looking forward to it. So let's look at Matthew chapter 7. And we want to jump in verse 12, and just a really short verse because it's kind of sandwiched in the middle of a lot of other things that Jesus was talking about. But in Matthew chapter 7, verse 12, he said, "Do to others whatever you would like them to do to you." This is the essence of all that is taught in the law and the prophets. Well, let's unpack that for just a minute because let's start at the end. The law and the prophets, what would that be? That would be essentially the Old Testament. So the law would be the books of Moses and the prophets would be all the books of prophecy. So all the things that were taught there can all be wrapped up in one thing. In fact, he said it's the essence of all that is taught in the law and the prophets. So essence, what does that mean? And I just did a little, dictionary search, but the essence of something is the intrinsic nature, indispensable quality of a thing, or it's the basic nature of a thing, the quality or qualities that make a thing what it is. So the quality or qualities that make the law and the prophets what they are is this commandment that Jesus gave, and that was do to others whatever you would like them to do to you. Now, I know we've been talking about a lot of these examples lately, but and I can't get away from social media. How many times on social media do we see words spoken that a person would never want spoken to them? So whether we're talking about family relationships or business relationships or church relationships, or maybe it's relationships that we form on social media, in any of these things, we want to remember that Jesus has commanded us to do to others whatever you would like them to do to you. And I think it's a good exercise for us to just pause and think real carefully, would I want someone to say this to me, or would I want someone to do this to me? Would I want someone to react to me this way? So it's just a good measure. But, so often, I think what's so powerful about this is so often when you think about the Old Testament, we think about it as an endless list of rules, do's and don'ts, and all of that. And yet Jesus said, the essence of all that can be taken care of with this one thing. If you'll just do to other people what you would want them to do to you. And so there's our challenge for today. Let's keep that in our mind as we're going through our day and whisper a prayer to the Lord to help us to do that as his follower, as his child today, to remember. It's so hard to remember in a moment of conflict, isn't it? It's so hard to remember in a moment of injustice or frustration or agitation. It's so hard to remember. But let's go out of our way today to remember to do to others what we would want them to do to you. It's a simple thing. We all learned this verse when we were just children, didn't we? But maybe as adults, we need a refresher. And let's try to keep that in mind as we go through our day today. Let's have a word of prayer. Father, thank you so much for all the things that you've given to us this week, done for us this week, all the answers to prayer that we've seen this week. Thank you, Father, for just sustaining us. Thank you for the safety that you provided. Thank you for the healing that you provided. All these things, Father, we want to stop and be thankful. And Father, we want to remember and ask you to help us remember to treat others as we want to be treated as we walk through our life. And Father, I just pray that you would have your will in each of our lives, that you would help us to remember as we enjoy all your blessings, that you are the source of our blessings. And I just pray for each and every person that's watching or listening to Noah's Window, that you would meet their need where they are today, whether it's a health concern or a family concern or an employment concern or a financial concern, whatever it is, Father, I just pray that you'd meet every need today according to your will and in your own time. But we're going to give you all the glory and the praise for all these things. And we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I hope you've had a wonderful week. I'm looking forward to this weekend. We've got a wonderful message, and the worship team has prepared a great service for us. And so I know we'll all enjoy that and have an opportunity to come in and worship together and praise the Lord. So we'll look forward to seeing you again next week here on Noah's Window. God bless.